Welcome back to Let's Play Steve Jackson Sorcery, or interactively play Steve Jackson Sorcery. I'm the RPG chick. This is, well, just explain like I normally do. This, you vote at the end for what we are to do next out of a list of choices, and we do that thing at the beginning of the next video. So make it a little interactive, as it were. The majority of you chose to turn back. Since we only have 4 stamina, these branches look evil. They're twitching and curling and uncurling like reaching fingers. Yeah. Let's not mess with that. I would like to find some berries or something like that. So I just want to remind you guys to please vote at the end, you know, in the comments below what to do at the end of the video. I had to put out a little reminder video, and I got a bunch of new votes, new people, you know, that have never voted on this series before, so I'm hoping at least some of these people, I have my hands together, praying at least some of these people will vote this time. That would be awesome. So let's turn back. You turn around and head back the other way, when suddenly you fall over. Somehow you have managed to get your foot tangled around a root of one of the bushes. Gonna try to untangle myself. I'm assuming that drawing my sword will just lead to a battle. You kneel down to work yourself free, but somehow end up more tangled up than ever. You now have branches around both ankles and one elbow. Okay. Maybe it's kind of like quicksand. If you stop struggling, you'll be fine. You stop quite still. And that is when you realize the bush itself is moving. Unfortunately, however, one of the tendrils has already looped itself towards your neck. Okay. Use an item? Before I get looped into that choice, let me see what kind of item that might be. Tinderbox? My question is, you know, I want to check out the spells. I don't want to use up the tinderbox. If I can cast some kind of a spell that will not take away my precious stamina at this point. Okay, wait, fireball, which will take away 3 stamina. Gob, conjure goblins. Yeah, goblin's tooth, I don't think we have that. Wait, that's a kin, maybe, or kid? Kid is... checking my notes here. Or I could just go into it, but enhanced illusion. Is a bracelet of bone. Fix? What? Cause fixedness? Let me just see something. It shows up red like that. Requires a bracelet of bone. Not red. It's the gob. We have nip. Cause speed. So I'm guessing when it's red like this. Did I say yellow? When it's red like this means we don't have it. We can like hastily try to untangle ourselves. Didn't work anyway. Rock. Turn to stone, it's stone dust. I think we got all of them. I'm going to try to use an item. You tilt your head down to peek into your pack. Perhaps you can get at something from in there. Use the essence of bark? I don't remember what that does. Is that magical? essence of bark? Let me check my clues. I don't want to use something that's vital here. I don't even remember what that's for. Isn't that sad? Oil. We defeated the fire serpent. Okay, I hope it's not vital. I'm gonna try to use that. With shaking, reaching fingertips, you reach into the bag and manage to snag the essence of bark between two fingers. Twisting your wrist, you manage to work the stopper free. The vial falls, pouring over the inside of your bag. The reaction from the strangle bush is immediate. The branches unwind and you are released. It seems it only attacks animals, but the sense of the essence is strong enough to confuse it. You step clear of the retreating tendrils defiantly. Okay, did I lose that thing? I guess so. Hope we'll be okay without it. Now I could head back to where I was. Right? Didn't I want to check this out? Alright, so let's head east, sort of. Southeast? South-southeast. You follow what might be a path, and might be an old river through the trees of the forest. You still feel shaky from your encounter with the stranglebush. The afternoon is drawing on. The smell of rotting leaf mulch fills your nostrils. You must continue your journey, but you are weaker than you realize. Perhaps you should simply rest here for a few hours and regain some strength. What do I feel like this is some kind of a trick? I'm just cautious about the smell of rotting leaf mulch, but I mean, that's not really out of place, but then why would it mention it, right? If I wait and rest, I may restore some hit points. If I move on, I may lose some, not hit points, sorry, stamina. Okay, I got back 7. Gratefully, or I got back 2-7, rather. Gratefully, you seat yourself and enter the meditative state taught to you by your masters. Really? I don't remember us ever going into a meditative state. A sensation of great peace enters your body. Hours pass. Clouds begin to rumble again. Across the darkening sky, it will be dark soon. You stand once more. Okay, so now we just rested and it's going to be night. South. Things rustle in the branches all around. The sun has almost set and the sky has turned a deep purple. Soon it will be dark. The trees are alive with movement. You continue on your way. Alright. Maybe we can find some food or something at this town. You do have some gold pieces, so if you can find some kind of merchant around here, possibly. The path winds tortuously through the forest. Darkness closes in. You should find a suitable spot to sleep. I just woke up. You have reached the edge of the forest. Through the trees, you can see the level steps extending into the night. Now might be a good time to rest before you go much further, I guess. Rest here. Laying your pack down by the roots of a tree, you try to rest despite the strange noises that float across the landscape. At least you have eaten once already today. Okay, hope you get back even more stamina. That'd be awesome. Close my eyes. Oh boy, no, giant bat! You stretch out and rest. You wake suddenly. There's a flapping of dark wings from overhead. A giant bat is circling above you. Your journey has been plagued by these feeble creatures. Are they truly feeble? I mean, we should fight it then. Well, let me see what we have for spells that might not take away stamina. Still trying to conserve that. We have Zap, which is Lightning Bolt. That will take up 3 stamina. We have Zen. Hover in the air. That's going to help a lot. It'll attack us anyway. We have Sap. Cause depression. I can make it depressed, maybe. S-U-S, sense danger. Well, we know danger is here. And create light, which we do have. I'm leaning towards sun, because we have a jewel studded medallion. And that won't cause any stamina drain. Might blind it in the darkness. Create an invisible wall. 3 stamina. That's all the W. Pop. Create explosions requires a pebble. I'd like to save those, if possible. Cause strength. We don't have fire water. I meant to click... I did W, right? Yeah, I did W. Yeah. Sun. Light spell. Huh. Well, it is kind of feeble, isn't it? You weave the spell and the sun jewel in your pack begins to pulse and throb with a brilliant blinding light. Light floods the trees. The bat blinks twice and attacks more ferociously than before. You will have to fight. Now, this does not use up the item, correct? Oh, good. I think I did have 2, but the other one was stolen, so... Yeah, it attacks ferociously, so defend. The bat's great wings buffet about your face. You drop into a defensive crouch, covering your head as the bat comes for you with claws and gnashing teeth. You escape mostly unscathed. The giant bat flutters upwards. And do a cut. Good. You wait for the creature's wide wings to open, and then you strike. Pushing off the tree behind, you thrust forward, catching the bat wide open. The giant bat tumbles backwards. It's tumbling backwards. Should I cut again? Another chance follows. You cleave the air with your sword. The giant bat tries to cover itself, but is too slow. The bat is moving erratically now. It flaps its wings threateningly, clearly trying to frighten you. I can only sideswipe, so I'm going to take this opportunity to just defend. Oh, I guess I should have sideswiped. You drop into a crouch. The giant bat tries to slice you with its wings, but you duck. It dodges higher. Damn. An opening appears. You bring your blade in heavily, almost slicing off the bat's stinging talons. You cut a strip from its wing. The giant bat ruffles its sleek, leathery wings intimidatingly. I love the descriptions of these fights. I'm sure I've said so before, but it's brings a lot of story to it than just, like, you did one hit point of damage. I'm going to take a chance and sideswipe, but it's got to be weak. Good. Bye-bye. The creature is now afraid. Swinging up from a low crouch, you aim for the beast's heart. Excuse me, the bat falls to the ground, and the light in its eyes goes dark. 2 stamina lost. Decent dueling. Why, thank you, game. The creature falls from the sky, dead. The light from your sun jewel pulses twice and fades. I wasted on that thing. The edge of the forest, day 6. During the past day, you reached the forest of Snatta and you defeated the fire serpent, the first of the 7 serpents. You wake with your head on a tree root and the smell of fresh dew in your nostrils. Time to choose a direction. I'm going to leave the forest. I will probably come back this way. Yeah, I don't know. Because I definitely want to check this out. And we have not checked this path, this bridge, this oasis here. Is another tower. But then there's a tower here that we have not been to. And there's something else over here. So I don't think I'm done with this area. I would like to explore all I can without dying, without having everything completely depleted from me. I don't know what that is. It looks interesting. Looks like the bridge. Yeah, it was a long bridge and it broke and... What happened to the rest of it? It broke maybe underneath. You can kind of see it, right? The same color. Not grayish? I don't even know. It's not greenish like you see around the other blotches, so the rest of this bridge might be underneath. But anyway, I do want to check out this town or whatever this is. Bunch of hovels or something? That stinks. Sunjewel. It was the Sunjewel. Maybe I did have two of them? One of them was stolen, wasn't it? Or was that another jewel studded medallion? I get them confused. All these jewels, you know. Let's leave the forest. Check this out here. Huh. You set off across the hard ground. The sky is blue and pink. The steps stretch away from here. As you walk, you see a strange sight. A village of listing huts in the middle of open space, with no walls or defenses at all. Ugly villagers lope from tent to tent, dressed in animal skins. And a bunch of savages here. Let's look at the village first. The men and women are strong and lanky, dressed in animal skins. By the gate, two creatures stand with hefty wooden clubs. Klattamen, like those that it costed you overnight. Alright. Should I cast my T-E-L spell? I cannot cast my T-E-L spell. What can I cast? Invisibility, which you don't have a pearl ring for. Summon a giant. I don't want to fight these guys right off the bat. We can grow in size. I guess just to intimidate them? Safe passage, right, right. I will probably end up casting that. Oh, create stench. Well, I don't have nose plugs. I don't think I've ever seen that one come up. Yeah. Oh, we did Y. B. H, how? That's it. Move on. It's probably going to tell me there's danger. Duh, but I do... If they have food, I would like to deal with them. I don't know. Then again, gold didn't interest them. I feel like casting the house spell would be a no-brainer. A path leads to the village, or you could skirt past. If I could somehow befriend these people... That would do well for me, wouldn't it? Hopefully they haven't heard what happened to their friends. You approach the guards. They look at you with expressions you cannot read. Look at them. You look them over. Perhaps they are in awe of you. but there was also a sly gleam in their eyes. Klattamen are quite literally subhuman, but they are not immune to bribery and gifts. Greet them? You nod in greeting. One of the Klattamen nods in reply and holds out his hand. The other Klattamen holds up two fingers. Maybe they would want gold pieces where the others wouldn't? Two gold pieces? You open your pack to consider what these guards might want. Two what? I'm thinking two gold pieces, but it can't hurt to ask, right? The Klattamen look at you blankly. Give them two gold pieces. You hand over two gold pieces. The Klattamen nearest you seems to love the shininess and takes the coins. The other stands aside to let you pass. They do not speak. Okay. So they've never seen gold pieces before, but that seemed to work. In the village. Maybe I can use more gold pieces. Keeping track, I do have 7 stamina, 13 gold. Just in case I unexpectedly lose some of that. You step into the center of the village. Okay, we got a large hut, we got a fire. Maybe some food I can have. I do have no food. You head over to the fire pit, but it is unlit during the day and there was no one here. That's funny, I can hear a fire burning. Go elsewhere. You look around the village once more. We could slip away? I mean, we came in here for a reason. Or check out the large hut. One hut is much larger than the others. Above its door is a sign depicting a picture of an awl and a hammer. It is amazing anyone here can draw, let alone perform crafts. From inside, you can hear the sound of hammering. Look through the window. There's a window? This is a tent. Peering in through the window, you see a Klattamen working away at a bench. He moves with unusual delicacy for these creatures, his long, thin fingers carefully adjusting the positioning of whatever it is he is working on. You can't help noticing he has an unusually large skull and is therefore exceptionally ugly. Maybe he needs an extra large skull for all that brain, because he's intelligent? Go inside. The Klattamen looks up as you enter. He puts down the tiny hammer and pinchers he has been using to repair a piece of fine jewelry, and tilts his head to regard you. Seems kind of rude to say, "Who are you?" Greet him. You greet him with a nod. He seems to understand this and nods in reply. Examine his workbench. You step forward and look over his workbench, and he gestures with an open palm to let you look. The Klattamen has a variety of fine tools, pinchers, awls, spikes for scratching and etching, even a vise. He is clearly a master craftsman, despite his species. When you are finished, he steps forward to you, gesturing for your pack. Show him my pack. You hold out your pack to him. He begins to rummage through, investigating everything with his long, supple hands, and occasionally pausing to scratch his bulging skull, as though his brain is itching at the sight of your gear. Then he digs around under his bench before finally pulling a long metal shaft and a hooked metal grip. He pushes the two together, screwing and clamping with a strange hooked tool. After a short while, he produces what appears to be a well-weighted longsword and hands it to you. I don't suppose he took anything. Now, of course, with the sun jewel, I realize I still have it, so I guess it fades, but we still have it. I don't know. Can I just take him? Can, I mean, take it. Is he just giving it to me? Well, he's handing it to me. So I'll take it, and if he wants payment for it, he'll indicate, right? Okay, I just took it. Alright. You accept the sword with a grateful nod. What do I have? Seriously? We have a longsword, plus two. Love it. I should pay him with my current sword. Ask him what he is doing. That's awesome. I'm glad I came in here now. Still, I need some food. I'm clearly pay for that. Pay for some food, that's for sure. Ask him what he is doing. You try to ask him what he is doing, but he ignores the sounds coming from your mouth as if they were just the banging and ringing of his tools. It seems he is carving jewelry from colored stones. They do not seem to be precious or even beautiful, but the weird twisted shapes he is carving are complex and intricate and remarkably precise. Can I just take a piece? It doesn't say steal one, or try to take it when he's not looking. Oh. You reach out to take one of the pieces, a bejeweled item of clear value. We lost 3 stamina. But he responds much more quickly than you expect, snatching up a strange two-handled contraption. He opens the handle and the device expands on a series of criss-cross bars. At the far end is a blade which skewers you through the shoulder, pinning you to the wall. He tilts his head the other way and, to make his point, wiggles the contraption, making your shoulder bleed. Release me, you demand. The craftsman listens with interest but does not retract the extended arm. Cast spell. Or I could beg. Nap? Oh, sleep spell? I don't have the item for that. Hover in the air, right, with a thing stuck through our shoulder. That'll work. Cause clumsiness? Requires 3 stamina, though. That'll leave me with 1 stamina. What was this other D? Cause slowness? I still would have to set to free myself. God? Oh. Would that work? They don't seem that interested in gold. Cause fear, black face mask, do not have. Requires a skull cap, which I do not have. This is nap, right? Did I look at everything? We have Y also. I don't know if I... invisibility. Pearl ring, don't have. Beg for release? You beg him to release you, appealing to all the gods and spirits you can name. The craftsman appears to respond when the name of... Hermrum? The cloud god is mentioned, and slackens his grip on the contraption enough that you are able to push it free and stagger clear. Leave the room. Bowing your head in supplication, you move backwards towards the doorway and then hurry out of the low hut. Well, okay. You win some, you lose some. We still have the sword, right? Yes? Okay. That was foolish. It should have been more... Or should I slip away or just leave? I'm afraid these guys are going to give me trouble. What if I just slip away? The village has no walls. You slip between two huts and back out into the plains. I was afraid they want more money. Oh, okay, there's my flags. Okay. I guess I'm gonna head this way to either this house. Looks like it might be a farm or something, maybe? A farmhouse? Or just a house with a well around back? And then we have... well, whatever this is. Stonehenge or something? And then we got this tower. So I will head south. You walk on, climbing slightly across the dusty steps. The moaning winds finger at your pack and sword. To the southeast, a huge mountaintop rises, its peak dusted with snow. It is the southern extent of the Horns of Ilklala. To the southeast, okay. Near its base is a carved shape, a turreted tower built into the stone of the slope. You must keep going, but your exertions have left you weak. Perhaps you should rest here for a few hours and regain some strength. Sure, will I get some back? Good. You squat down and try to relax your body and mind. You feel a great peace. Mid-afternoon heat makes the air sticky. The time has come to continue your journey. All right. South. You keep moving, the ground dropping a little. Slowly the sun begins to make its way back down the sky. The scrubland is broken quite suddenly by a small waist-high post to which is nailed a written notice. Of course we're going to read it. You pause to read the sign. The writing is crabby and difficult, but you slowly decipher it. Stop, traveler. Every wish can come true, for this post marks the grave of the god Benanga. Call his name and close your eyes to be blessed forthwith. What, there's got to be something with this writing, right? I'm looking to see if it spells out anything. Because we got denter or T-T-E-R-E-Y wish. No. For no. Okay. What is it, Zen, that we're looking for? No. We want how. What's the other spell that's... sense danger. Consulting the stars, you bind the magic and a steady voice enters your mind. The voice indicates that there is some danger here, but it does not specify what it is. The spell fades. I don't know. I'm so curious, guys. So I'm going to leave it here. Yeah, what do you think? Should we call the name Benanga? Since there is some danger, maybe there's some reward as well? Or should we hold on to our 6 stamina and walk on and just forget all about this Benanga stuff? Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Let me know in the comments or what your vote is for the beginning of next episode. And until then, endure and enduring, grow strong. See you next week.